but I'm finally going to start my 2016 MLB The Show franchise. And, you know, I'm a Cardinals fan. Most of you know that if you watch some of my videos. So it's going to be the Cardinals. I'm going to go with the Cardinals. Some people, you know, don't like it because the Cardinals are a little bit better. But this year it's going to be tougher because the Cubs are a lot better. So it's going to be a big challenge to go out and beat the Cubs. But first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to let you take a look at one move I made. I made one move that is pretty huge. All right here you can see in the yellow, acquired right-handed pitcher Antonio Bastardo and the big bat Michael Conforto. And left, actually, that's going to be a closer. That's a mistake. That's closing pitcher Akil Morris, who's a B potential from the Mets, for shortstop Johnny Peralta, Brandon Moss, and Jaime Garcia. I hated to give up Jaime Garcia, but I really didn't have a choice. I had to do it if I wanted to get Michael Conforto. That's what I'm going to do is I'm going to move Matt Holliday over to first base. But here we'll take a look at my lineup. Here's how it's going to look. I got Grichik leading off. This is probably going to change. Colton Wong may end up leading off. But we got Grichik, Carpenter, Conforto, Holliday, Piscotty, who I'm expecting big things from, Molina, Wong, Matt Adams, and this is with the DH, Adamis Diaz. So I think Diaz is going to be huge. I hope he does just as good as he is in real life. But here's without the DH. Grichik, Carpenter, Conforto, Holliday, Piscotty, Molina, Wong, Diaz, and Wainwright. So let's take a look at my pitching staff. We got Wainwright, Martinez, Waka, Mike Leake, and Lance Lynn. Because in my world, Lance Lynn is not out for the season. But here's a look at my bullpen. We got Seagrass, Broxton, Maness, Juan Ho. I'm going to leave that like it is. Then I got Jordan Walden, Antonio Bastardo. He's my setup. He's going to be huge. And then Trevor Rosenthal as my closing pitcher. So we're fixing to get this going. Going to play the first game of the season and see how this goes. First, I do need to do one thing. Dude, don't want that there. We're going All-Star, All-Star. I play All-Star on everything, just so you know. Make sure I got that all set up. Apply the changes. Back to home. Next game, Adam Wainwright versus Jared Coe. We're going to get this thing going for opening day. Quick counts are going to be on. We're going to go hybrid. That way it'll go through a little quicker. Let me get on my channel so if anyone has anything to say, I can respond to you. And like I said, it's been a long time since I've been on here. So maybe I'll see a lot of old friends. Yep, we got Wainwright going. Staying with that lineup. And here we go. Game one, opening day. Hopefully we'll come out with a winner. This is going to be a tough matchup with Cole. And I haven't played in forever. I've been so busy with school and work. And I help coach my daughter's softball team. So it's going to be see how this goes.
Now from the north shore of the Allegheny River, there's a beautiful look at PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Opening day is here as we get the new season underway with a good matchup between the Cardinals.
I just love the Cardinals. I mean, I think all of you know it if you watched my videos from before. Huge Cardinals fan.
Again,
you can see my cap.
It's finally here. Welcome to our special opening day edition of Baseball on the Show. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, as we get set to get things going, it's the pitching that has to be considered one of the strong points.
Yeah,
on
the
this
Pirates
ball
are going to be, I think they're going to be pretty good this year.
Pitching is going to be important for these guys, no question about it. They're only going to go as
thanks,
far
Coyle.
As this group
is that
right
Coyle
Withrow? And to me, it looks
I like the Pirates, but go Cards for franchise. Yeah, I hope.
The game's count
it's going to be tough.
Now.
You know, you got the Cubs and the
it's
Pirates.
Opening day.
It's really going
it's
to be
the show.
tough to win this division, but if you watched any of my franchise last year, I made the playoffs, ended up getting beat by the Nationals. So hopefully this year in franchise I can get it done, and I will complete this franchise. I mean, I will go and hopefully make the playoffs and get a World Series run. But we're going to go ahead and get this going.
Back now as we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 Pittsburgh Pirates.
And now
take a look at my lineup again here.
Set by Mike Matheny. Steve, what's their focus as they
here
go
we got
for
Grichik, Carpenter, Conforto, well, Matt, Holiday, Piscotty, Molina, Wong, so Diaz, and Wainwright.
Ground, focus on hitting line drives and play small ball.
Take a look at the Pirates here.
With a moment now, let's give you a look at how the Pirates align defensively. It's brought
David
to
Freese, you know, former Cardinal,
EK,
third base now.
Well, guys, somebody you don't want to test in this outfield, the left fielder. He's got a very good arm, very aggressive, charges balls extremely well, and covers a lot of ground.
Cole into the windup. Here's the 1-1. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
2-1. Should get something decent to hit right here.
Belted,
oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
Marte
get going. Get going. Get
track,
out of here. Wow. Lead
and
off home run.
Goodbye.
Wow.
This one ain't coming back.
And I, if you saw from the start, I do all my hitting in all-star difficulty, and I can't believe that. Grichik leads the season off
so
with a home
run.
Run
here,
wow.
Off the ball game. And the Cardinals
cannot believe that.
Front,
great start.
Nothing.
Great start. Man, 391 feet. Couldn't
well,
start out any
you,
better.
Guy at the top of the lineup that's capable
boom, look
of doing
at that.
This, boy, that's a great weapon to have. He jumps all over this ball to lead off the ball game with a solo home run.
Matt Carpenter.
So here we got Carpenter. We got to keep Carpenter going.
After the leadoff home run to start the ball game, does the game plan
I know,
Coyle,
that was awesome. I can believe it. Thanks for joining my
but
broadcast, though. I really appreciate it. If you haven't, check out my channel. It's Dan Up Late Gamer. I got a lot of videos from last year. I got some. One Diamond Dynasty from this year.
No offer on
that. That's
it.
Looks like Jarrett Cole just doesn't have any control this game, so hopefully we can jump on him.
Well, accuracy is always appreciated with umpires, and Fillmore, he's no exception. He'll miss one here and there, but it's really pretty rare from what I hear.
Ah.
He pops him up over toward foul territory. Trevelli is
that's
camped
be
under this
out.
One, and he puts it away for the first down.
Batting third.
Now here he is. Here's Michael Conforto. He's the newest Cardinal. I love this guy. I think he's going to be huge. Hopefully he can make up for losing Jaime Garcia.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And now a curve.
That's way inside.
He's got to lean out of the way. That one
Cole just really doesn't have any control.
Bases are empty. One man out. Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
3-1. I should get
on
something
deck,
really good to
Matt
hit here.
Matt Holliday, he'll hit next.
Ah.
Too close for comfort.
Should have let that go.
Good job just to make contact.
Oh, wow. That's going to get through, though. Middle. Oh,
Harrison,
no, it's not.
It. Throw on to first, two gone.
Should have let that go. That would have been a walk.
Batting four. First baseman number 7, Matt Holliday.
Now here's Holliday. As I told you, I've got Holliday in at first. He is not going to play left field this year. Oh, late on that. Should have let it go. Oh, what am I swinging at? Holliday goes down. That's going to end the inning. But you
but
can see his Grichik. Look at this.
Shot,
boom.
Off the ball game. On to the bottom of the first at PNC Park. And the Redbirds have an early 1-0 advantage. And here's how Clint Hurdle set his Pirates lineup for this one.
Take a look at Pirates lineup. Polanco, Harrison, McCutcheon, Marte, Jaso, Cervelli, Freeze, Mercer, and Cole.
So you need to stay out of the double play situations and work counts.
3-2 count. Boy, they ain't helping me out, are they?
Gregory Polanco, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. Good battle continues as this ball's chopped foul at the plate.
Definitely not helping me out.
Grounded up the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2.
Rips this one to first. And get over there, get over there.
So the pressure's on to open up the
inning.
Running hard, he's digging for second.
Lead off double, just like that.
Off the bag.
Oh, he had to be sitting on this pitch because he was all over it. This is a curveball. Not really a terrible one either, but he guessed right and he yanked.
Now we got Harrison. Another 3-2 count. Come on.
Here's the 3-2. Ripped on the ground.
Whoa. Get over there, Holiday. There we go.
Wow.
Almost blew that.
Andrew McCutcheon.
Finally, not a 3-2 count.
Now, so maybe an important at bat here early in the ball game.
Yeah, I think you really need to get something out of this inning, even if it's just a sacrifice.
All right, that's going to be, that should be an out. Run's going to get home,
but the run will come in to score.
So we're tied up 1-1.
You pick the double to start the inning off, and then it's all about get him over and get him in. And two straight ground outs do that job.
Starling Marte bats now and will try to start over with the bases empty and two away following the RBI ground out.
Nice pitch there by Wainwright.
2-2 now. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now. 3-2.
Yeah, after that last swing, I would have thought they'd go right back in, but that's actually
go get it.
I doubt he was looking for something out there.
See, that's what Conforto can do that Holiday can't.
They'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. So it's one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on base.
Second
inning
coming
up
from
PNC Park, all tied at 1-1. Stephen Piscotty will lead things off in the
I know quick counts will do that, but the game would last forever if I did that.
Cole's ready. Here's the 1-1. Hit high.
Oh, get down. Get down. Get down. Oh, whatever. Yeah, he caught it.
What a play there for
the first
play.
Just an outstanding play out there by the outfielder. And the guy who appreciates it more than anybody is the pitcher.
Real nice play by Polanco.
You're looking at some trouble.
Standing in now, Yadier Molina.
Oh, come on.
Little chopper back his way. Throw gets him. Two down.
Yeah, you do. I do quick counts because I want these videos where, you know, if somebody wants to watch them, they don't have to spend an hour and a half.
He's got plenty of time out there, so he's able to set himself and then make a good, strong throw.
Into the box, Colton Wong. Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. 2-2 now with two away and the bases empty. Bases are empty here with two men out.
2-2 count.
Swing
yes,
hard
that's
liner
get
to left center.
Yes,
and
that'll get
finds
out.
Some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Batting eight.
Diaz set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap to give that man on first a chance to score.
Runners on the move for second.
Yes, just like I wanted it.
And that finds its way through for a base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
So we got runners on first and third.
And now
here's Wainwright.
No happier person in the ballpark. Pitcher number 50. Diaz.
Now I'll tell you,
first hit as
last season, that's Diaz's first
there,
hit
the
in the majors.
Into the dugout,
last season, MLB The Show 15,
you know,
Adam Wainwright hit a home run
in
the on opening day.
Player,
so maybe he can get it. He can do it again. We'll see.
Like, but there's quite a difference.
Oh man, I give him an 0-2 count. Really?
And then actually getting that first hit.
Stepping in now.
Come on. So that ain't gonna happen.
Cards strand a couple. We'll go to the bottom of the second, tied one apiece.
Well, that's tough.
John Jaso will lead things off here as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1 and 2.
Oh, crap.
Right side, but he will come on strong out there and right and pull this one down for the
first
out.
That was ripped.
Well, that one looked like for all the world it was a sure single leading off the inning.
I'm a lot happier with my outfield with Grichik, Piscotty, and Conforto than having Holiday out there.
Into the box now, Francisco Cervelli hits this one hard the other way. Throw on to first will get him. Scored at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two.
Here's David Freese, former Cardinal.
David Freese gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Hit hard to the right. Foul. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning.
I got to score some runs. It's only the third inning, but I like scoring runs.
Through two, we're tied one apiece. Rendell Grichuk is into the box as we are all set to begin the third.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started, set the table for a little bit of a rally.
Cole gets the sign, looking to put him away here on a ball and two strikes.
Ah, nice slider.
Swing and a miss as he starts the third, the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away. Third baseman, Matt Carpenter is into the box for his second at bat. He popped out into foul territory his first time up.
And he popped up a high fastball last time, so maybe they feel like they can beat him upstairs. We might see that same pitch again in this
nope.
at-bat.
Hit hard on the ground to second, and that's through for a hit. Michael Conforto stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out.
And Matt, with the double play in order, they'll obviously
should definitely
be looking to
get a good pitch
another
here.
Ground ball out of him right here.
Oh,
it's Taylor made the short six.
Should have let that go.
Three.
That was a ball.
It's a double play, and the inning
that's
is over.
That's inning over just
Red
like that.
Redbirds down quietly. After 2.5, it remains a 1-1 ball game. Jordy Mercer digs into the box in the bottom of inning number 3.
We will play sometime, Angry Mark. Thanks for joining. I've been watching some of your WWE reviews. I really like them.
It swung on and hit
oh,
in the air.
Come on.
Toward
oh.
the line and right. And that'll get down for a base hit.
All right. Held him to one. He was going to try to dive for that, but I just don't think that would have happened.
This one looked like one of PK's four irons. He just kind of shanks this thing right down the right field line, but he manages to drop
there's another look
just
at it.
Inside the chalk line.
I just don't think I would have got to that. Yeah, he's going to sacrifice that. Why do I have these manager tips on?
Standing in now, Garrett Cole. Nope, now this pitch sails up
yeah.
and in.
Get off the plate,
muttering
bud.
To himself. It's ball two.
He did not like that one bit. You know, it's one thing to work in with the hard stuff, but don't do it around the dome.
And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works.
I'm definitely happy to see Seth Rollins back in WWE.
So that's a good
I haven't got to watch your latest
right
one.
There.
I saw where it went up. I'll watch it later tonight.
Second base with just one out.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And, ooh, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now.
Well, that may have been a borderline call right there.
Awesome,
you know,
angry Mark. I'll definitely be looking for that. I've got you on, I'm subscribed, and I get all the alerts when you post videos, so I'll definitely be checking it out. 2-2 count here. Uh-oh.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Grichuk moves over, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Yeah, I didn't think he was going anywhere. Almost messed up and grooved that for him.
Now, Josh Harrison, and he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here.
Oh, and it's so important to take advantage of these kind of opportunities early in a ball game. It can change the entire complexion of the game if you can put the other guys on their heels right away.
Has to be thinking strikeout here.
Slack come on.
The opposite way. That's in there.
Come on,
baseline.
Get him. Okay, they're going to hold him up.
And the runner at third.
Nice throw by Piscotty.
So didn't want to chance it even with two outs.
Man, I got to get.
Check this out. This is on the inside part of the plate, but he's still
I had him
able 0-2. To take it to the opposite field.
I'll nice you, play by Piscotty there.
Right there.
One ball, two strikes.
In now, Andrew McCutchen.
Oh. Link
making contact on that swing, and we'll do it again.
This guy can kill you.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And a sinker dips.
That's
a
bad pitch.
Into the dirt, in fact.
And this is all about having faith in your catcher that he's going to block that pitch as well he should. He's one of the best around when it comes to smothering.
I needed
balls
to reset on that.
Hit high and
oh,
deep
you gotta be
right
kidding
here.
Me.
Scotty ranging back.
Oh.
On a fence scraper, but still good for
three run
three
homer.
Runs.
Oh my gosh. That kills me.
So it's a three run shot to straightaway right field.
My pitching is definitely rusty.
Now, 4-1.
Wow, look at this. Here it is. 347 feet. He barely got it out of here.
You can see the location mistake there. And now, all of a sudden, he goes from possibly hanging a goose egg to.
See, let's take a look at this. See, just. Yep. Man.
Into the box, Starling Marte. Drilled on the ground to short.
Definitely got to rattle the bats now.
Plenty of time and the side is retired.
Down 4-1.
But the Pirates plate three in the inning, all coming on this three-run home run. We're through three
Man.
Here in the Steel City. It's now a 4-1 Pittsburgh lead. Leading off the inning, Matt Holliday. And they'll need him to get something going here. Cole has his target. Here's the 1-1. Outside 2-1.
Definitely got to make Cole throw strikes. He hasn't been throwing a lot of strikes. Yeah,
slider
there we
misses,
go.
And he's in danger of losing him here. 3-1.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been.
If you can get Robin Yount, if you've got almost
you
all
bounce.
The Milwaukee Brewers. Hang on.
And he
all
lays
right,
off
walk,
lead off
so walk.
Lead-off
I'll take it. But yeah, if you can get Robin Yount, man, that dude, that his legend
not
can
when you wanted to come
definitely
back
hit.
Your guys just scored you three runs in the previous Steve half inning.
I mean, you want to at least make these guys earn their way on. Now he's going to need a ground ball.
Oh, man.
That one's fouled off.
Should have ripped that one.
Swing and a line
get down,
drive.
Yes.
And this continues right on through.
I'm gonna have to hold up.
It down. And that
it's all right. Nobody
no
out. Runners
second
on first and
there
second.
Are two aboard now.
Well, you know they're scoring this one a base hit, but I'm not so sure I agree with that. Here
how can that
again.
Not be a base hit?
Really not that tough a play, and you probably
oh, whatever.
Should
that's
able
a
to
hit.
Two on this play, but instead. It skips right by.
Okay, here's Molina.
Passing out hits like that. Give me
1-1 count.
Yadier Molina will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far.
He's
so this might be
safe.
His first real test of the ball game.
Here it comes on 1-1.
That's a terrible pitch to swing at.
One and two.
And sometimes you got to cut down a little stride against a guy who's throwing this hard. Either you take that leg kick completely out of the equation, or you get it started just a little bit quicker.
Lays off. Ooh. Two and two now.
Glad that got out.
One run, five hits, and no errors.
Man,
so
Aaron Mark, that is really good.
Full
all right,
count.
3-2 three count.
And two.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you
he's
want
to throw
on
strike
two and
here.
Two. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
And that's missed by Molina as he sat down on strikes for the first down.
Oh, that's just a blazer right there.
Not what
he
I
says,
wanted.
I'm not trying to get you to chase.
Needed to make contact on here.
And he throws it right past
okay, here's Wong. 2-2 count.
Into the box now, Colton Wong. Still 2-2.
You see me jump when I hit? I do that every time.
4-1 our score as we play inning number 4. Here's a swing.
That's
and a pop-up.
Pop
up.
Man, oh, man.
Toward the third base dugout. And Freese will look this one in, and there are two away now.
My record online is like, I want to say 3-4 or 4-3. I haven't really played online that much.
Here with two on and two out here in the fourth.
And a big two-out at-bat right here. You know, it's still early in this game, but
okay.
You don't want to have to look back on this.
I need to get somebody up in the bullpen just in case. Segrist does, just in case Diaz just does get on.
And he lays off a pitch down and away, ball two.
You know what? He's starting to skate on some thin ice here, and sooner or later, he's going to have to challenge him.
Oh, man. Oh,
late,
man.
It's 2-2 now. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
Got him looking.
Oh, come
and
on.
That ends the inning. Cards strand a couple.
Man.
They trail it
2 guys on, get nothing. But yeah, Angry Mark, I haven't played hardly at all online. 4-1, going to bottom of the fourth.
John Jaso
definitely got
a
hold
off
him
in the home half of the fourth inning,
and they jumped out to that early lead. So now it's all about just adding on.
Man, I keep laying it right down the middle.
That one away, and he stays alive. Ready to deliver the 1-2, and another foul ball. Guide in the air to
get on back there, Conforto.
Conforto has to retreat a bit, but he gets there for route number one.
Now batting.
I'm not, as you know, if you watch my franchises, I'm not ruling out any more trades. I may make some more. Don't know yet.
Sliced hard on the ground.
I thought I was going to come up with that.
He can't make the play. It's a base hit. At the plate, David Freese, who looked to
here we got
back
Freese.
After striking out his last time
up. Got a runner on first.
Fastball last time, so let's see if they come at him with the hard stuff again.
Way outside, nearly to the
two
backstop.
Balls,
two
one
and
strike.
One. Two
there
and
we
two.
Go.
Now you got to beware of that.
Man, that
sinker.
Home run by McCutcheon
right now, but I think
just hurt
still
me
just
so badly.
A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2.
Boy, I don't know about the Cardinals this year. The Cubs are awfully tough. Cardinals are playing just about 500.
Time. Takes this the other way to right. Piscotty is there to put it away. And the
another good play by Piscotty. But the Cardinals, they're just playing about 500.
Well,
Cubs
right
are playing
there.
Really
he
well.
He's not trying to pull it.
I don't know how it's going
to
go this year.
Just happens to be right at the right fielder.
Stepping in now, Jordy Mercer. Chops it foul at home plate as the count moves to 2-2 now. Fought off at the plate and we'll do it again.
See what I want to do here.
Pretty well struck high and deep to
come on, Conforto. You're going to get there. You're going to get there.
Back.
still going.
Yes.
Back.
See, he's Conforto, man, he helps me so much more than Holiday out there.
But they lead it 4-1.
Okay, I'm going to leave Wainwright in there. Going to leave him in.
We'll step in now to lead off the inning as his guys look to maybe break.
Going
to
go ahead and
yeah, and after that first Seagrass, inning, I'm going to sit him down. Zeros since. And once he kind of got settled into that groove, he's been a difficult nut to crack.
Grounded to short. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
But I got to score some runs. Come on.
Randall Gritchick strides into the box now. Launched one over the wall back in the opening frame.
Oh, what am I swinging at?
Cervelli recovers, and that's he makes horrible. The throw to first. Gritchick is retired.
Two outs,
down
just
now.
Like that.
Matt Carpenter will stride in. Popped out and singled in his two trips.
Yeah, and he made just a little adjustment last time coming off of that pop-up the first time around.
Oh, way that's out in front. Yeah, the Braves aren't.
Up the middle,
oh, come on.
Leg.
Nah, he's going to throw him out. But yeah, the Braves aren't going to win anything. Now, in a couple years, that may
nothing
be good.
Across here this half. Last half. Garrett Cole comes to the plate. As
I don't understand the Twins.
The
I mean, they got Buxton and Sano. And who is it? Dozier. I just thought they should be a lot better, I feel.
Wainwright into the windup, coming home with the 1-1 pitch.
I guess
and
it's their pitching.
And a curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now 1-2.
Now the Reds, yeah, they're
good sinker there. Gets
they got it rough being in the National League Central.
Gregory Polanco will stand in. He flew out his last time up.
Gregory Polanco.
Hit hard to short.
Come on, Diaz. Got it.
Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now. Two away.
The batter, number 5, second baseman.
Josh Harrison will dig in. 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. And
oh, nice play by Holiday.
First as he pulls that
he's been
one
practicing.
In to end the inning. A scoreless half inning there from Adam Wainwright, but his club trails 4-1.
I got to get it going.
Michael Conforto makes his way to the box to lead us off in the sixth inning.
They've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
Now it looks like a right-hander's up and throwing in the Pittsburgh bullpen. And that one never
threatened
the
zone. Okay, should get something good to hit
here. Now to 3-2.
Don't want to lose the leadoff hitter here. Not when you got this guy on deck.
Bounce towards the second baseman. Gloved by Harrison. Throw to first.
I think that was
so
going to be a strike.
Retired here to begin
first
the sixth.
Number 7, Matt Holliday.
Digging in to try it again. Matt Holliday. He drew a walk his first time up. Ready on 1-2. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number 2.
I don't think so.
You know, seems like every time we check these out and show motion.
Yeah, he kind of went. Wow, the bat came clear out of his hands. And somehow it stayed right there.
I don't think he holds up in time. Looked to me like that was the right call.
Steven Piscotty will come in now with two away. And to this point at least, so much for having the 3-4-5 guys get the rally started.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's been an important inning for that man out there on the mound. He's held his ground and he made
it. Yeah, the Reds, I haven't really paid attention to the Reds.
The 1-2 pitch. That misses, and we're even at 2-2
count.
All right, now you just
yeah, the Reds bullpen. I'll take your word for it because I haven't
away.
Really
so, as a hitter,
watched them that
you're
much.
You're going to eliminate that pitch. No way does he throw it a third time.
Left side. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. When we return, it'll be Andrew McCutchen to start things out.
Yeah, I do,
it's
but I don't.
Pirates 4,
I don't really like
Cardinals
to make the
won.
Interdivisional trades because is the Pirates really going to trade Marte to
Andrew
the Cardinals?
Will step
I don't think
here,
they would do
does,
it.
We flash you back
that's
to
just kind of
a
little too far out there.
Run,
I mean, I will make some other
on.
Crazy trades. I mean, I'll get guy like Conforto. Would the Mets have really have traded Conforto to the Cardinals? I don't see any way they would do that. But I really like the player, so I want to get him.
Wainwright looks in with the payoff pitch. Pitch swung out and hit in the air. In there, a base hit. He's around first on his way to second.
He's probably looking for three.
And he's all right,
we're going to hold
safely.
Him up. Okay,
he's
this looks like
double.
The last inning for Wainwright.
It's never an easy task to have to start an inning by going through the three, four, five guys. And obviously, no exception here because he drills this ball, and he's going to wind up at second with a leadoff double.
Get oh, and Seagrass up. Oh, terrible. Oh, wow, thank you.
Awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. A swinging bunt to the mound.
Come on.
And with his speed, forget it. It's an infield single.
You're kidding.
What a great way to start the inning. They want to keep putting on the pressure. This puts runners on the corners now with nobody out, and they've got a good chance to add on to this lead and maybe even put this
one
away.
Boy, did he help me out.
Well, that's been the go-to pitch when
he really helped me out.
He definitely needed it there.
Francisco Cervelli steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And now the Cardinals get the bullpen working here. Both a lefty and a right-hander have stood up. Bounced slowly back toward the mound. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the run.
I don't think I
would
have got him at home. I may have,
yeah,
but.
A chopper like this, probably the right decision not to go after that guy from third. So he wisely just takes
I don't think I would have got him.
And he allows the run to come home and score.
Going to try to get Wainwright through this inning.
Lined out in his first two at-bats. 1-1, here it comes. Down the first baseline. And a heck of an effort over there at first, but it'll
think
be
that was a foul ball.
This is a foul ball. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2.
All right.
Swung on and missed, and that's
that's
going to
pretty much be
inning.
It.
One in the inning for the Pirates on a couple of hits.
We're yeah, I know. That's kind of how I am. I play
Pirates
late at night.
Top, 5-1.
That's kind of where I got my name from because I played so late. So, figured, you know, Dan UpLateGamer.
Back here in Pittsburgh, it's on to the seventh inning with the Pirates leading in this one. But before the inning gets underway, let's check out the game summary to this point.
All right, let's get some hits.
Now in the Pirates bullpen, they've got a lefty and a right-hander up to throw.
Little
now
late.
A swing and a ball hit foul to first as the first base coach had
yeah,
to
it's 11-13 where I'm at.
There. All even at 2-2, here it is. And he struck
man.
Him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ballgame.
Eight strikeouts.
Colton Wong will stand in. He's singled and popped out in his first two at-bats.
3-2 count. Come on. Let's rip something.
Ready to deliver the full count pitch. And here's a ball
how
hit
about
in the
a
air.
Pop-up?
Cervelli waits on it.
I'm making Cole look
he
like a freaking Cy Young Award
there
winner.
Are two away.
Now batting, number 36.
Diaz will stand in now. He's singled and struck out in two trips. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Down low, two balls and a strike.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch. Something to get a base runner and give that guy something else to think about out there.
I thought that was going to come down a
bit. At 2-2. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Tough fastball that time, but he hangs with it.
Okay,
to
he's
going to
come with something off speed. Maybe it's probably
two
a slider.
Two count, here it comes.
Lofton okay, get out. Get,
right
yes. That's going to be in the gap. That's going to
be
two. Should it go three?
Around second. He'll try for third.
I think they would have nailed me.
Make it back to second.
All right,
and be
bring in the pinch shooter.
There.
Yeah, and he had his first major league hit earlier in the game. How about a two-hit game to start things out? Atta boy.
Yes, I do want to do that. Okay, who am I going to bring in? Righty.
Number 41 is out of the dugout now, as it looks like he'll come on and hit for the pitcher, Wainwright.
Hazelbaker. He's coming
one
in.
One run, six hits.
Need a big hit.
And no errors so far for the Redbirds. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Boy, what a nice job so far of working himself into a hitter's count. Now he can go to work.
Really needing to come through here.
Two-out RBI out of the nine hole.
Oh. Down the third baseline. Freeze is there.
Run.
And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. Time for a quick break, then back to PNC Park.
Jed was a righty. Going against a righty, I had to bring a lefty in. I couldn't have, if it was a left-handed pitcher, I would have brought Gorko in. Trying to say, okay, we got a righty.
On opening day.
Number 26.
Jordy Mercer will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far.
And you know, I think he's had a good approach in each of his first two at-bats. He seems to be seeing the ball.
It's basically one at-bat did this game in for me, the McCutcheon.
And two and two.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on two and two, I don't think you fool around anymore.
Hot shot to third. And he's retired one away. Garrett Cole will buy himself another at-bat, and in turn he'll get himself a
good,
nice little ovation for the work he's turned in on the mound so far.
He's been great. This is an appreciative crowd. They like what they've seen, and I don't blame them.
Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. And a swing and a miss there on a late-breaking slider as he set down
on
strikes for the second time this
afternoon.
And with strike three recorded there, he's notched
his first major league strikeout.
Bet his club is hoping for a lot more of that going forward.
Well, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to be a solid one. Many of the best pitchers at this level have at least one put-away pitch that they can go to in tough situations. So we'll see if he becomes one of those guys as his career goes along.
And that
all right, I got two more innings. Got to score some runs.
Down in order go the Pirates. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Rendell Grichuk will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Matt Carpenter gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it.
Oh my God, that was ball.
It's one and two now.
Boy, it's one thing for a reliever to come in out of the pen and throw 100 miles an hour for 15 pitches or so, but he's right up there around the century mark now, and he's still throwing hard.
That was my fault.
Pitch working now as he notches number nine.
Boy, this isn't looking good for opening day.
Will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
Grounded back.
That's going to get through there. All right.
And that gets through, so he'll have his first base hit, make him 1-for-4 in the game now.
Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now. So he may be getting just a little bit tired.
Oh, man.
Tapper right back to the mound.
Way out in front of
that. First will get him easily, and the side is retired. Cards leave one. They're down 5-1.
Not looking good.
Josh Harrison will start out the inning here for the Pirates, to be followed by Andrew McCutcheon waiting on deck. 1-2.
And that's right where you want to be with your specialty pitches. If you can start him knee high and let him dip out of the strike zone, you'll have a lot of success with locations like that one.
Well, O's doing good.
He reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out.
Oh, and that's a good pitch right there. That's just a hard-breaking slider down and away. And you get the hitter to be
enticed by
that pitch.
Here's McCutcheon. He's the reason I'm in deep crap, this guy. Look at this guy.
Then it just flat disappears on you, and you're left wondering.
Nice play by Grichuk.
Under this one is Grichuk, and there are two away now.
Left fielder.
Starling Marte steps in now. And he looks at ball four now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
Now batting.
John Jason will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk. Marte off for second. Pitches a cold strike. The throw.
Whatever.
Way late, and he's in there easily at second.
And I think everybody in the ballpark knew that he was going to be running with two away. But even when you know it's coming, he's still hard to get a handle on. And he's in the scoring position now with that stolen base.
And a fastball. Tough take there, but it's even back at 2-2.
And against a veteran hitter like this, you got to be in that strike zone early in the count. Because the more pitches he sees, the better he's going to be able to time anything you've got.
Thought he might go after that.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches. He's laid off a few pitches like that.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here.
Last chance.
One left for Pittsburgh. They're up 5-1.
Piscotty, Molina, Wong. Yes, McCutcheon is a beast.
Starting to start the ninth, Stephen Piscotty, and they'll need him to get something going
2-1
here.
2-1 count.
They're facing a pretty big deficit in this game, so they need to start clawing their way back.
Come on.
To the left side.
Come on, Piscotty, dig.
Close play first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one. Yadier Molina will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs.
Yeah, and you just can't worry about the score right here. You just got to be able to string together a couple of base runners and take it one pitch at a time.
Polanco's not able to get that. Thank goodness.
Trying to strike him out for the third time. Here's a ball.
He won't that time. Get
down. Out toward right center. And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow.
Can't believe that.
Very tough play here in the outfield. A lot of times you're going to see the ground jar the ball loose, but he looks this one in all the way.
Is Polanco? Polanco is good, but is he that good?
In now, Colton Wong. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2.
I'm not going to pinch hit for Molina. Who am I going to bring up? I mean, I got to have a catcher in case like a miracle happened. And I did score.
Pulled high
four.
In the air out to right field.
Polanco, whatever.
Has it in his tracks, makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Opening day didn't go the way I wanted it to, but you know, you got to play 162 games. So lose the first one. Really, it was really just one pitch. I could have hit a lot better, but that three-run home run by McCutcheon just really did me in.
One more look at the final line.
Yeah, McCutcheon, 2-for-4, two runs, a home run, four RBIs.
To the victory. And guys, I think you might agree, there's little doubt that the star of this afternoon's contest was this man.
Definitely should have been
McCutcheon. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he was definitely a big part of this victory. You see there, four RBIs.
Lose 5-1.
He came through when they needed him to.
All right, well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it.
So
this is my first episode of my St. Louis Cardinals MLB The Show 16 franchise. And I will be completing this franchise. So you're going to see at least one playoff run. Hopefully I make it. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.
2 hours and 50 minutes.